Welcome back to Clicksuasion. This is your host, Michael Barbera. As promised, based upon your requests, we have a new format. This is your 5 minutes or less consumer behavior news for March 18th, 2019.
Why is the shopping cart always in the top right of the screen?
How do companies predict my purchases?
Why do prices end in 9?
Why do fast food companies use red and yellow in their logos?
Why do restaurants always have one expensive menu item?
Researchers, marketers, and very curious people seek the answers for how we make decisions and how we choose products. Clicksuasion finds the secrets that companies use and shares them with you.
Why do I feel better when I bought the last remaining airline ticket?
How do I make choices based on colors and fonts?
Welcome back to Clicksuasion. This is your host, Michael Barbera. Let's discuss consumer behavior news, March 18th, 2019. Let's talk about the Sunshine Protection Act. At least a few Central Florida residents have warmed to the idea of permanent daylight saving time and getting an extra hour of daylight in the afternoon, even if it means working another dark hour in the morning. The Sunshine Protection Act won support in the legislature last month and was signed into law by the Florida governor, but needs congressional approval to take effect. In a push for federal change, Senator Marco Rubio and Congressman Vern Buchanan proposed legislation last month calling for daylight saving time to become the new standard, ending the semi-annual changing of the clock. In recent years, several states in New England, Maine, Massachusetts, New Hampshire, and Rhode Island have created commissions or introduced proposals to that end. Staying on daylight saving time could have a particular benefit in New England, which, as the easternmost region of the sprawling time zone, endures very early winter sunsets. In the parts of Maine, for example, between Thanksgiving and Christmas, the sun is likely to set before 4 p.m., more than an hour earlier than it does in Detroit, on the other end of the eastern time zone. This can mean more electricity use and more symptoms of seasonal affective disorder, not to mention less after-work shopping, which takes an economic toll. But changing time zones could have an economic cost, especially in a region like the Northeast, where millions of people commute across state lines. No one wants their office to be an hour ahead of their home. Aware of that, most of the New England states contemplating a change made it contingent on their neighbors doing the same. So researchers estimate that additional daylight in the evenings would reduce the number of robberies and found that extending daylight hours could save $59 million per year in avoided social costs. Additionally, researchers estimate that your employees would experience a reduction in the frequency and risk of car crashes by increasing visibility for commuting drivers. The biannual changes overwhelmingly disrupt the synergy between farmer schedules and supply chain partners. And a 2008 study by the Energy Department saw that the extended daylight savings from a 2005 law incurred energy savings. With today's technological advancements, the World War I era German motive of energy conservation is now rendered irrelevant and should no longer serve as a reason to continue this outdated practice, state some people at the federal level. Sales by time of day and how daylight or lack thereof may affect your business model. Some businesses that might experience an effect in the change or in their sales book because of the change are coffee distributors or coffee manufacturers, tourism, public health organizations. How will daylight saving times affect your business? Are you an adversary or an advocate? Time will tell. For Consumer Behavior News, this is Michael Barbera, North Carolina.
Thanks for listening to Clicksuasion. Subscribe to the podcast, read our research, and get in touch with us at clicksuasion.com. You can also find us on Twitter with the handle @clicksuasion.